Warning, I will insult you and the creators you enjoy in this video. This video is a joke, but if you don't want to hear that, get out. The biggest event on the Dream SMP just turned a year old. Fans are losing their mind because there's barely any plot progression and you don't know where to start? Oh, I'm sorry, does the concept of research scare you? Oh, I know, the lore sounds complicated, but believe me, it isn't. Even someone as pea-brained as you could understand it with a bit of time and effort, but you're lazy, so I'm gonna have to drag your sorry self through this. Context. Hi, I'm Annie. Today we're going to be explaining the most basic storyline ever to morons who couldn't keep up with it, despite it becoming the most popular Minecraft server ever in the past 2 years. These absolute nincompoops have proven themselves incapable of watching more than 5 minutes of video without losing their focus, but to be fair to them, every Dream SMP lore explained video is so boring, the normal person has fallen asleep by 4 minutes anyway. If you know someone like this who might benefit from having lore spoon-fed to them like some sort of overgrown baby hungry for pseudo-political block game roleplay, feel free to share this video to them so they can be handheld through clicking the YouTube play button. Okay, our main objective today is to understand the basic gist of the Dream SMP so that you get at least the first two levels of the Dream SMP iceberg. We'll also be picking up a few extras along the way, so let's get started. In the start, our main characters are Tommy, Tubbo, and the rest of the Dream Team. Before the heavy lore started, these guys were busy figuring out the point of the mask or whatever, and the server got pretty big. Wilbur and Schlatt both joined, and Schlatt got banned from the SMP Live because of Twitter drama, and there were a bunch of SMP Live bits that were recreated on the Dream SMP. The next thing you have to know is that this entire SMP refuses to budge from the bit that is kinning Bloody Hamilton. Well, mixed with another show where the mentor's first name also starts with a W and second name is a color. Wilbur started a nation to get a monopoly over potions or drugs, and that is how Lemanberg was created. Given that it was literally just a bunch of walls with a male-to-female ratio of literally infinity, it did, well, ish. There was a pretty cool anthem that was made while Tommy and Tubbo were singing to a patch of mud. They also lost 100% of the wars they got into while fighting against the rest of the SMP for independence, but that's pretty much expected when your vice president can't go 5 minutes without unironically saying the word PogChamp in full. The president, Wilbur, was known for his silver tongue and also managing to be desperate enough to marry and have a son with a fish. Yeah, a fish. Bit of a leap from an e-girl, but it's not like you could do any better anyway. Everett then betrays them, surprise, surprise, the one character who wears sunglasses isn't trustworthy. No. Not yet. I've already made an entire video about bloody gender man over here. God, could you guys be any more demanding? Anyway, after getting rolled by discount fruit berries and the average group of e-boys on PvP Legacy, Tommy decides to really play up the Ludwig clone bit and double or nothing risk it all on a final deal with Dream, and promptly loses everything, including two music discs that he cared so much about that they were probably like the kids pop version of Blitz by Technoblade or something. At some point, Bad Boy Hillo's self-proclaimed e-boy joined the server. I'ma be an e-boy! And then Dream tried to justify mass murder with the theft of a fictional table. Anyway, Quackity proceeded to raid the server like for some sort of Club Penguin clone and started running for the president of Lemanberg alongside a man whose defining character traits include not being able to see color and wearing an overpriced thing that he calls art. So he's basically running with a crypto bro. Wilbur and Tommy did a little bit of trolling by adding back an alcoholic goatman to endorse them in an election that they rigged. Said goatman then 10,000 IQ MLG plays them by teaming up with Mr. Habbo Hotel over here to win the election, exile them out of the country, and tear down the walls. Tommy and Wilbur then start an entirely new nation in a cave called Pogtopia, once again showing off their unmatched ability to name locations, where Technoblade also finally logs onto the server after getting bored of bullying a college student in a block game over potatoes. I'm not explaining the potato war to you imbeciles, but if you want a video on that, feel free to like and subscribe, because it's basic knowledge at this point. The first potato war has over 27 million views. If you haven't seen it yet, you must be living under a rock. Despite your sheer idiocy, there are standards. You guys work hard every day to continuously push them lower, but we're not there yet, thankfully. Goatman then decided to completely alienate the server's entire audience by referencing Game of Thrones, but honestly, people who call the server's audience 13-year-olds give people like you with the mental age of a 5-year-old a little too much credit. At the Red Wedding, the Red Festival, Techno pulls a hashtag relatable moment and succumbs to the peer pressure of murdering a child in cold blood. You know, the usual. Tommy throws a hissy fit about this and challenges Techno to a fistfight, and it's so bad you can't look away. It's like watching a bug challenge a car windshield to a boxing match. Anyway, after a while, Techno and the rest of the ragtag volunteer army in need of— oh my god damn— the winner of Mr. Beast's $10,000 duel with Dream and the rest of the army attack Manberg and then win, successfully stressing out Schlatt enough for him to have a heart attack and just keel over on the spot. Watching Schlatt die gets Wilbur all nostalgic, so he then recreates the dumpster fire that was Minecraft Monday by doing a fun little game of Find the Button with all the theatrics you'd expect from a theatre kid like him.
It was never meant to be.
It was a good trade-off though, because in doing so, he managed to finally get his dad to come back from the store and just straight up stab him in the stomach with a fire aspect sword.
How heartwarming.
Techno then destroyed what was left of Manberg with withers. Tommy and Rambo teamed up to absolutely dunk on a presumably sleeping Goggy by destroying his house, and Tommy got exiled by his best friend because Dream decided to install the Minecraft Betrayal mod on the server. Unfortunately, it was not 1000% funnier. Wilbur also came back as a ghost called Ghostbur. Ladies and gentlemen, a creative genius, at around this point. Green Blob then lived up to his title of Minecraft YouTuber and manipulated a child in the wilderness for about 2 weeks. Since this is fiction, however, his actions had consequences, and Techno took in Tommy after he burrowed underneath the man's base like some sort of severely traumatized mole man and started embezzling from him. Techno then channeled his inner politician and gave a lofty ideological speech, something that'd certainly fly over your head, and committed various war crimes. He then decided to team with Phil to recreate TNT Run on top of the barely rebuilt Manberg, traumatizing just as many orphan- well, children as he claimed to have done back in Minecraft Monday. While the world is crumbling around him, Ghostbur adopts a sheep and names it Friend. How wholesome. Look, this video is stupid enough as it is without us talking about how Ghostbur canonically dated the thing, okay? Tommy and Tubbo then team up to get Tommy's discs back because they're what we call friends, probably an alien concept to you antisocial pricks, and then meet up with Dream. Dream then rolls them in PvP and subsequently shows them that he's been manipulating the entire server like it's some sort of mods folder. Then, as all hope seems to be lost, Charlie Slimeskull, wait, no, sorry, Puns, leads the rest of the server to save the duo, and they finally get their discs back, ending a war on a server that went on for so long it almost certainly broke records. I certainly wish those records had been broken much sooner. This could have been where the story ended, but it isn't, because existence is suffering. Anyway, Dream gets sent to prison where Sam is the warden part-time and a stripper the rest of the time, and the only food he's fed is raw potatoes. It would have been a bit more fitting to give him celery, but it probably would have been insensitive to feed a tasteless green stick to another green stick for an equally tasteless pun. Tommy then decides to literally face his fears and visits Dream in prison, and then gets locked in with him. That must have been a real nightmare. I already hate myself for laughing at that. Anyway, Tommy's killed by Dream using a potato and revived by Dream using a revival book. And I guess that means you could call the potato he used to kill Tommy a hesitator. And you stop. This is a problem. I can't help myself. God damn. While Dream is in prison, Quackity does what any person with no morals these days does and gets rich off of NFTs. Okay, maybe it isn't canon that he got rich off of NFTs, but this guy certainly wasn't adding any value to the SMP. And then he turned around and started a casino, so you tell me how he got his money. He also teams up with Sam, who at this point had managed to misinterpret doing no harm to visitors to doing no harm to them and has cut off Punk's left arm. I mean, I guess he's alright now? Carl, while this is all happening, somehow unintentionally starts time traveling in a series called Tales from the SMP, and honestly, I was going to write a funny time traveling joke here, but none of you laughed anyway. I've said idiot too many times this video, hold on. You galoot. Ha! Yeah. Insult. Oh, and while all of this is happening, there's a weird egg thing that's spreading beneath the SMP. It's malevolently mind controlling a mass of morons who make numerous nemeses while naively nurturing and nourishing the newborn nuisance. So they host a horrendous hoolie to help wholeheartedly hoodwink the uncontrolled hordes and hatch it while the humble habitue try to harm it with a hatchet. Quackity then teams up with Sam to try and get the revival book from Dream by just straight up abusing the man every day for like 80 days straight. While this is happening, Tommy decides to try and get his revenge on Dream and leads Ghostbur into prison with him. Here's a totally unrelated excerpt from Wilbur's podcast for a quick second.
I love permanence, man. I think permanence is so important. If a character dies in a story, they need to be fucking dead. They are gone.
Anyway, so yeah, Wilbur gets revived. Quackity then starts a new country called Las Nevadas and courses a fox, a god who is beaten by Bad Boy Halo and a Hypixel Bedwars streamer, to join him, and then tricks Techno into visiting Dream. Techno, who anticipates that it might have been a trap, gives Phil a way for him to get out, but Phil takes so long to read the way to free Techno that he might as well have, you know. Anyway, Phil frees Techno from prison after 3 months, Dream is still stuck in the cell, and you have proved yourself to be as much of a moron as I claimed you are by actually watching through this entire dumpster fire of me attempting to be funny without 4 actual insults. However, you should definitely watch this video if you enjoyed this one. Subscribe!